All right, hi everyone. All can hear me?
Yes, sir.
Am I audible to all, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So were you all
yes,
aware
sir.
About the timing of the class? It was at 4:15.
Yes, sir.
Right? Class was at 4:15. How many of you know it is at 4:15? How many of you don't know it is at 4:15? Class timetable would have been given to you, right? It was scheduled from 4:15 to 5:30.
Yes,
the
sir.
Newer one. Right? So join at 4:15. So many are yet to join. We'll just start in 2 minutes. I'll just post in the group and come, because most of you have not joined. Just 1 minute. I'll just return. All right, so yes, everyone, we used to have class at 4, that is right, but the new timetable would have been updated to you, that is from 4:15 to 5:30, okay?
All right. Sir, the time was updated in the description.
In the last classes, we talked about the resultant of the two vectors. याद है रिजल्टेंट देखा था हमने एंड वी ऑल्सो डिड फ्यू क्वेश्चन सो वी बेसिकली सॉ रिजल्टेंट ऑफ टू वेक्टर्स व्हेन द टू वेक्टर्स आर परपेंडिकुलर राइट ओनली द परपेंडिकुलर केस वी हैव सीन So before we move ahead, let us do just two questions to recapitulate what we have learned, so that I be sure that you are all following up. Two forces are acting on this object. These two forces are acting on the object like this. 3 newtons and 4 newtons. You are required to find out the magnitude of net force and its direction. So before everyone joins, let us do this question, all of you. Whoever will be done, they will press here yes, and that will give me an idea how many of you have done this. Done this third part. Okay, to determine the resistance, that's also okay. Yes, I saw the answer. What happens to air resistance as the stone falls? So air resistance increases because air resistance is described as a function of its speed. Okay, it is described as a function of its speed. So if speed increases, air resistance will increase. Okay, let us do this one. So everyone done this? Two forces acting on the object. You must also take into consideration air resistances, but here air resistance is not mentioned, so we will not take that into consideration. Okay, so these are the only two forces here acting on the object. Quickly, quickly, everyone will do. I can see only 20% of you have attempted. All of you will do this. Okay, so we can discuss it now. So the two forces here are perpendicular. So the net force will be 3 squared plus 4 squared, and that shall give us 5 newtons. We have talked about this expression in the last class. Iska resultant kis direction mein hoga? Is direction mein hoga, right? How to get the idea of resultant? Both the vectors should start from the same point. So I can relocate this vector. Isko idhar rakh diya aur isko relocate karke idhar kar diya. Now the direction will be in this. To find out the direction, we can get the value of theta here. Right, this is clear to all? Right, we have gone through the triangle law. Okay, one more before everyone joins. All should attempt this one. So find the component. Here you have to find the component. If a force is acting in this direction, that is, let's say 12 newtons, and the net force is in this direction, that is 30 newtons. So some force is acting along this y-axis. So you need to find the component of the force acting along this y-axis. So quickly all will do this. And the last problem, 90% of you have done. This also let us target 90%, and then we'll move to the next discussion. Quickly, all will do. We have already discussed them. Only 50% of you have attempted. Quickly, we will do this. Still, I can see only 70% of you have done. Just rearrange the forces in all the directions. Sabhi direction mein forces ko rearrange karenge. We shall get the idea. You have to just find the component. यू ऑलरेडी हैव द नेट फोर्स, जिसमें से कि एक कॉम्पोनेंट हमें दिया गया है, दैट इज 12 न्यूटन. सो वी विल यूज द सेम फॉर्मूला. We will put in the same formula here, and it is also given that the other forces along this line. So, kya hoga? Take this force, put it here, because from a point, two forces should start. So, ye ho gaya 12 newton. Let us say this force is x. So, we get 13 squared is equal to 12 squared plus x squared. So from here we get x squared as 169 minus 144, and x comes out to be root of 25, which is 5 newtons. Jitno ko 5 newtons mila, I can see the chat, they are correct. 25 newtons nahi hoga, root 25 newton hoga, right? Ye dhyan rahe, root 25 newtons honge. So before I move on, let me know, यहां तक में कोई doubt है, completely ये समझ में आया, then only it will be good to move ahead. Anyone has any doubt, they should let me know this first. Chalo, I probably guessed no doubt here. Okay, so if no doubt, then we will do one last question based on the direction. So this is vector A. This is vector B, this is vector C, और ये रहा vector D. You all should find A plus B is equal to C plus D. A plus B is equal to negative of C, negative of D. A plus B plus C is negative of D. और A plus B plus C is equal to D vector. So you have to select which one out of them are right here. Hello, that's very good. Almost all have understood whatever we have talked. So yes, you can select your choices here. So most of you, I can see they have selected A. but still only 60% of you have attempted. So let's take one more minute and everyone should do this. Sabhi koi karenge. Component of the vector, it refers to that part of the net vector. Chalo, I can see most of you have selected option A. Aur yahan par dhyan dein, to A option hamara sahi nahi hai. The right option is option C. Option C is the right one, which only few of you have selected. Ab C kaise correct hoga, dekho. A vector plus B vector. So I can cut them and I can write this as A vector plus B vector from triangle law, right? I can cut them, A vector or B vector ko cut karke, I can write this as A vector plus B vector. Now I can cut this A vector plus B vector and C vector and I can write in this direction as A vector plus B vector plus C vector. Right, I just combined the vectors. Now we can see ye jo vector hai, blue vector or red vector, they are exactly opposite. So dono ko kaise likhenge? A plus B plus C is equal to D ka agar hum negative dekhenge, so it will be in this direction. So this vector is now equal to this vector because they have same direction now. So this will be our answer. Is this clear to all? Is this clear? A vector kyun nahi hoga? Hai na, agar ye ho gaya hame, ye agar mil gaya, to theek hai, isko rearrange karo, D ko idhar lete aao, B ko udhar lete chale jao. So you'll get A vector plus C vector plus D vector is equal to negative of B vector. It can also be A vector plus B vector plus D vector is equal to negative of C vector. You can rearrange. So based on this only, we can simplify the expression. Bhai, ye agar koi doubt puch rahe hai ki how is A plus B plus C in the negative downward direction? Ye maine aise hi downward direction thodi le liya. I have used triangle law, very simple. Triangle law, multiple times we have understood in the last class. Triangle law mein kya tha? Ye agar A vector hai, ye B vector hai, to ye A plus B vector hoga. To wahi to humne yahan apply kiya, jo humne mila A plus B plus C downward direction. So directly you can say to me to explain once again. Chalo, phir se explain karte hai. There is no issue in that. फिर से एक्सप्लेन करते हैं। चलो, ये रहा ए वेक्टर, ये रहा बी वेक्टर, ये रहा सी वेक्टर, ये रहा डी वेक्टर। ए वेक्टर एंड बी वेक्टर कैन कंबाइन, तो इसका रिजल्टेंट ये होगा, दिस विल बी ए वेक्टर प्लस बी वेक्टर, राइट? बिकॉज वी हैव, इफ दिस इज ए वेक्टर, इफ दिस इज बी वेक्टर, देन दिस विल बी ए वेक्टर प्लस बी वेक्टर। दैट मीन्स फ्रॉम द इनिशियल पॉइंट टू द फाइनल पॉइंट द एडिशन ऑफ दीज टू वेक्टर्स विल बी देयर। सो नाउ आई कैन रिमूव दीज टू वेक्टर्स एंड आई कैन सी दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग ए वेक्टर प्लस बी वेक्टर। सेम थिंग आई डिड इट हियर, ए वेक्टर प्लस बी वेक्टर फ्रॉम द इनिशियल टू द फाइनल पॉइंट, this is my a vector plus b vector. Now what I did, this is a vector plus b vector which we have formed, and a vector plus b vector, and if I add c vector, from initial to the final this will be a vector plus b vector plus c vector. Direction is always from initial to the final. So now we can cut them, and now we can see a vector plus b vector plus c vector is in opposite direction to d vector. That means invert the d vector and then I can equate it to a plus b plus c. So we will get a plus b plus c is equal to negative of d vector. ठीक है, फिर से समझाती है। नाउ एनी क्वेश्चन एनी वन ऑफ यू हैज? भाई ये बी और सी ऑप्शन कैसे सेम हो जाएंगे, बी और सी कैसे सेम हो जाएंगे? ये दिस इज अ वेरी लॉजिकल थिंग, ए प्लस बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस सी। अच्छा, इसको ऐसे लिखना चाह रहा था मैं, ऐसे लिखना चाह रहा था, राइट? इरेजर यूज किया होगा, ये हट गया होगा, दिस इज नॉट सेम। हाँ, इसके पहले जो है ना, ये अगर जो दिख रहा है ना आप लोगों को, देन इट वुड बी सेम, है ना? माइनस सी वेक्टर इधर ले जाएंगे तो प्लस हो जाएगा, देन इन दैट केस बी और सी दोनों बात बराबर है, बट मैं जो चाह रहा था वो ऐसा चाह रहा था, सो इट विल नॉट बी बी, सी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर। नाउ एनी वन हैज एनी डाउट इन द ट्राइंगल लॉ? नो। अच्छा चलो, नाउ so Rohan will tell me this answer, especially I'll ask you from the end, a plus b plus c, ye answer nahi, Rohan will tell us the answer, baki sab bhi karenge, all will tell me the answer privately. This is c vector, this is d vector, this is e vector, and this is f vector. So all should find the value of a plus b plus c plus d plus e plus f vector. And Rohan will tell us this answer. Aur jinka ho jayega, they will message me here. only 40% of you have done. We have done this kind of question now. Just now we did this kind of question. बस मैंने ये दो साइड इसमें एक्स्ट्रा लगाया, ये वाला क्वेश्चन किया हमने, सेम मेथड वी विल अप्लाई फॉर दिस वन. जल्दी 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 सब करेंगे. सिक्सटी परसेंट ऑफ यू हैव डन. रोहन विल टेल अस द आंसर. जो भी मिला लेट मी नो, लेट मी सी क्या मिलता है आंसर. वन आंसर आई कैन सी इट करेक्ट. ध्यान से करेंगे इसको. Eighty percent of you have attempted. Rohan will tell us the answer. A big hint, sabhi koi. It is exactly the same one what we did in the last problem. So same way we will do. Ye A plus B, I can remove them and I can write here A plus B. And again I can remove this A plus B and then this C I can combine and I can say this is my A plus B plus C. Right? So I will remove which is not required, which we have already combined. Now I will combine A plus B plus C and D. So this will be our A plus B plus C plus D. A plus B plus C plus D. And this one and this one can be combined now. And I'll get in this direction a plus b plus c plus d plus e, and that should be, let us check it once again. But understood the flow, guys? Let me draw here again and we will do this. A, ye b, ye c, ye d, ye e, and this was f. So a b ko combine kiya idhar mila, usko combine kiya idhar mila, isko combine kiya idhar mila, and then these two I will combine, so we will get a plus b plus c plus d plus e, that will be in this direction, right? This we have got it as a plus b plus c plus d plus e, and this, if you observe, it is negative of f vector. So I have asked, what is the value of this? So take this minus f vector to left side, you will get plus f vector, and the result will be zero, a null vector. Is this understood to all? ये समझ में आया? जिनको डाउट्स है दे विल आस्क मी नाउ, बिकॉज वी विल बी हेडिंग टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक नाउ. नो डाउट्स, ओके? ऑल राइट. Whoever wants to note this down, they can note it. क्लियर है ये? दिस इज क्लियर टू ऑल गाइज, राइट? चलो फिर ठीक है. सो नाउ वी विल सी, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी सॉ दैट हाउ टू कंबाइन टू वेक्टर्स एंड फाइंड इट्स रिजल्टेंट इफ दे आर परपेंडिकुलर. दैट मीन्स इफ द एंगल between the two vectors were 90 degree. So we will see now, if the angle between, let us say this is a vector, this is b vector, and angle between them is theta, what will be the magnitude of resultant? So is this clear first, ki iska resultant kuch is direction mein hoga? Is this clear to all? That may be due to connection error. My video off कर देता हूँ. So this b vector we will take it here, right? This b vector is here, and this is our resultant vector. We have just used triangle law again. Now we will find out the magnitude of this resultant vector. So let us find out the magnitude. So this was, let us say, a vector. I'll make it little big. This was our b vector. So iske direction kya hai? Ek ka direction idhar hai, ek ka direction idhar hai. Then resultant vector we get in this direction, right? This is our resultant vector ka direction. This is b vector. This is b vector, this is a vector. Now what I will do, I will take this b vector and I will reposition it here, because yes, we can reposition that, or reposition karne ke baad hi hum triangle law lagate the. To ye jo resultant vector hoga, that will be here. So this is our B vector with magnitude B. So can I say that this angle is theta? Can I say, because B vector idhar tha, dhyan se dekhe. So this line and this line is parallel because they are in the same direction. So this is a transversal. So this and this angle should be equal because they form corresponding angles now. Okay. So now what we will do? I'm just extending this. I'm just framing a right angle triangle. Just observe. ये 90 डिग्री पे मैंने कंस्ट्रक्ट कर दिया. सो दिस ए वेक्टर, इसका जो मैग्नीट्यूड है ए, दैट इज फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर. और बी वेक्टर का जो मैग्नीट्यूड है बी, दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग दिस लेंथ. कैन एनीवन फाइंड आउट दिस लेंथ? यू हैव थीटा, यू हैव बी. इफ यू ऑब्जर्व दिस ट्राइंगल, उसमें अगर हम कॉस लें, कॉस थीटा, सो दैट विल बी एक्स रिप्रेजेंटिंग दिस बेस डिवाइडेड बाय हाइपोटेन्यूस बी. तो एक्स क्या हो जाएगा? बी कॉस थीटा. सो दिस विल बी बी कॉस थीटा. वैसे ही साइन थीटा लगाएंगे तो ये हाइट क्या हो जाएगा? बी साइन थीटा. सो बिफोर आई मूव ऑन, इज दिस क्लियर टू ऑल? नाउ वी नीड टू फाइंड आउट द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ दिस रिजल्टेंट. मैग्नीट्यूड मीन्स आई हैव टू जस्ट फाइंड आउट दिस साइड ऑफ दिस राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल. So I'll use Pythagoras theorem. Hypotenuse square is equal to base square. Base kya hai? A plus B cos theta. And height kya hai? B sin theta. Okay. Now R square, let us expand this. X plus Y whole square. So X square plus Y square. Plus 2xy, that means 2ab cos theta, plus square of this, so b square sin squared theta. Now this is a trigonometric identity, that sin squared theta plus cos squared theta is equal to 1. Jo bhi abhi tak bhi trigonometry nahi dekhe hain, they will watch all the trigonometric videos. I have already uploaded that in my channel. Usme ye sari cheeze maine discuss kiya hai, complete क्लास टेंथ का ट्रिगोनोमेट्री मैंने डिस्कस किया है. यू ऑल कैन गो थ्रू दैट. सो कैन आई कंबाइन बी स्क्वायर कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा एंड बी स्क्वायर साइन स्क्वायर थीटा? यस, आई कैन कंबाइन. बी स्क्वायर कॉमन लिया तो साइन स्क्वायर थीटा प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर थीटा बन गया और ये क्या हो गया? वन. सो बी स्क्वायर इंटू वन, सो दैट इज बी स्क्वायर ओनली. तो मैं इन दोनों के जगह पे आई कैन जस्ट राइट डाउन बी स्क्वायर, और ए स्क्वायर तो था ही फ्रॉम हियर. And then 2ab cos theta. And this was r square. So r kya ho jayega? R will be root of this. So guys, this was the proof to get the magnitude of, it was the magnitude of resultant of a vector and b vector at an angle theta. So this formula we will remember. Now we should also get a way to find out the direction of resultant. So let us say resultant vector is at an angle alpha maan liya. So from the same triangle I can find out alpha. Kaise find kar sakte hain? Tan alpha is perpendicular, that is b sin theta, by base, that is a plus b cos theta. So how should we write the result? Alpha as tan inverse b sin theta by a plus b cos theta. You can see the expression looks to be complicated, but we are just taking the sides of the triangle. That's the thing we will keep in mind. So all can note this down and then we will sum the result and then we will do the questions. Quickly, everyone will note it down. let me reshare it again. Screen fluctuate ho raha hoga. Okay, yes, now the screen is fixed. Any doubt, let me know. Anyone has any doubt, they will ask me now only. So let us summarize what is this which we have to remember. So this was the proof. More than the proof, we need to require the way to remember and use them. So what is the thing? That if we have two vectors, right? These are the two vectors. So iska jo magnitude hoga, that magnitude will be at some angle alpha. Or alpha kaise nikal sakte hain? Using tan alpha as whatever is here, just use sine with that. And then a plus jo idhar hai uske sath cos. This is the way to get the direction of resultant vector. Now what is the magnitude of resultant? Root of a squared plus b squared plus 2ab cos theta. You can see with respect to that magnitudes of two vectors and the angle between the two vectors, I am able to get the direction of resultant and the magnitude of resultant. Right? This is the magnitude of resultant vector. Alpha is the direction of resultant vector. So only these two points we need to remember. Now, if you remember these two points, then we can also get the result for the two vectors which are perpendicular. Ye jo resultant ka formula hai, a square plus b square, when they are perpendicular, that we can get from this one only. What is theta here? 90 degree. And you all should remember, cos 90 degree hota hai 0. So, agar cos 90, ye agar 0 ho gaya, to ye sare terms 0 ho jayenge. We will be only left with a square plus b square root over. So now you can see, this is the only thing which we need to remember. Ye agar yaad ho gaya, so any case we can find. We can find the magnitude of resultant and the direction of resultant if the vector is at any angle theta. So from now onward, we will try to use this result. Okay, so let me know who all have understood this, including the proof. Ye raha iske proof. Thank you. यस वी कैन स्क्रॉल इट डाउन, वही है जो रिजल्ट हमने ऊपर प्रूव किया, दैट इज द ओनली रिजल्ट हियर. Let us do a question based on this, what we learnt. Let us do a question based on this. Two vectors of magnitude, or let us say we have the two forces acting on the block here. This is the block. One force is acting in this direction, that is 10 Newton. Other is acting in this direction, that is also 10 Newton. You have to find the magnitude and direction of resultant if the angle between them is 120 degree, and this has been given to you. Cos 120 is minus 1/2. Everyone will find this out. Yes, everyone will do this. जल्दी जल्दी सभी कोई करेंगे. यू हैव द फॉर्मूला फॉर द मैग्नीट्यूड्स. रिजल्टेंट का मैग्नीट्यूड क्या है? रूट ऑफ ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस 2ab cos थीटा. एंड व्हाट अबाउट द डायरेक्शन? टैन इनवर्स बी साइन थीटा बाय a plus b cos theta. So you have to just use this formula. Only 20% of you have done. I have given you the formula again. You are just required to remember the formula. हाँ साइन 120 भी आई विल गिव यू. दीज ऑल थिंग्स यू कैन गेट आफ्टर गोइंग थ्रू कंप्लीट ट्रिग्नोमेट्री ऑफ क्लास 11. बट अभी के लिए वी हैव टू बी गिवन विद दीज वैल्यूज. साइन 120 इज रूट 3/2. क्विकली क्विकली एवरी वन विल डू. ओनली 50% ऑफ यू हैव डन. बस फॉर्मूला में यूज करना है एंड देन यू हैव टू गेट द रिजल्ट. Let us see what we are getting here. Root of the magnitude will be root of a square, that means 10 squared. B is also 10. 2 times a into b into cos 120, that is given as minus 1/2. So this will be root of 10 squared is 100. 10 square again 100, and then this will be minus 100. So that will be 10, right? The magnitude will be 10 units only. And at what angle? Let us find that alpha is tan inverse b sine theta. That means 10 times sine 120 divided by a plus b cos 120. So from here we will get alpha as tan inverse 10 root 3/2, that will be 5 root 3 divided by 10 minus 5, that is 5. So we get alpha as tan inverse root 3. So this is a standard value. If you will go through the trigonometric videos, from there I can say this angle is 60 degree, right? Else you can also leave the answer like this. That means this will be the resultant at an angle 60 degree with 10 newtons. So what does this resultant mean? Ki in dono force ka jo effect hoga, their combined effect will be this 10 newton at 60 degree angle. Okay, is this understood how we got the magnitude and how we got the angle showing the direction? समझ में आया सभी को? Okay, let us do another question then. A ball is thrown at 37 degree with respect to horizontal. You are required to find ball is thrown at a speed of 10 meter per second at 37 degree with respect to horizontal. Find the horizontal and vertical component of speed. Quickly, we will do this one. So whoever will be done with this, this is the last question for today. So let us do this very efficiently. Dhyan se padhenge question and we will attempt it. बस 10% लोग किए हैं, ये तो हमने लास्ट टू लास्ट सेशन में ही ये डिस्कस कर चुके थे. थ्रू द चैट आई एम गेटिंग राइट आंसर. हियर यू हैव टू जस्ट लेट मी नो हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव डन. रोहित कुमार पुहन हो गया. रोहित रोहित विल टेल अस द आंसर. यस रोहित, व्हाट विल बी द आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन? हॉरिजॉन्टल एंड वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट क्या होगा? If the ball is thrown at 10 meter per second at an angle 37 degree with respect to horizontal. If you all would have remembered, I have told you to remember a triangle जिसमें ये 37 degree होता है और ये 53 degree होता है और ये 90 degree होता है और ये side 4, ये side 3, ये side 5. ये अगर याद रखेंगे तो हमारा हॉरिजॉन्टल कॉम्पोनेंट क्या होगा? जस्ट फ्रेम दिस ट्राइंगल. यू हैव 10 ओवर हियर, राइट? ये 10 जो है दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग दिस साइड. व्हाट विल बी दिस साइड? देखो 5 था तो 4 है, 10 होगा तो क्या होगा? 8, राइट? और यू कैन से 10 cos 37 इफ यू वांट टू यूज cos. और cos 37 फ्रॉम हियर वी कैन गेट व्हाट इज cos 37? दैट इज 4/5. सो इफ यू पुट हियर 10 टाइम्स 4/5 हमें रिजल्ट मिलेगा 8 मीटर पर सेकेंड. इन द सेम मैनर इफ दिस इज 5 दिस इज 3, सो इफ दिस इज 10 दिस शुड बी 6. और इफ यू डू नॉट वॉन्ट टू यूज दिस रेशियो देन दिस साइड विल बी 10 साइन 37. दिस इज जस्ट प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ वेक्टर्स. इन द वेरी फर्स्ट क्लास वी ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ वेक्टर्स. ओके, सो दिस विल बी 6. Because sine 37 will be perpendicular, that is 3, by hypotenuse, that is 5. Okay. So I'll give you a summarized note what we need to remember in complete vector. So, pehle to triangle law, the important ones I am giving. Triangle law, ye ek vector hai, ye dusra vector hai. तो इसका रिजल्टेंट किधर होगा? इधर होगा. दैट विल बी ए प्लस बी, राइट? ट्राइंगल लॉ इज ओनली यूज टू गेट द डायरेक्शन, यूज टू गेट डायरेक्शन ऑफ रिजल्टेंट वेक्टर. देन वी सॉ कि अगर डायरेक्शन मिल गया तो मैग्नीट्यूड कैसे मिलेगा. सो मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ रिजल्टेंट इज गिवन बाय रूट ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर प्लस 2ab cos theta, and theta is the angle between a vector and b vector, right? We saw this first. We also saw what will be the direction of resultant. So that will be tan inverse b sine theta by a plus b cos theta. And finally, you can remember a result regarding projection of vector. Ye bhi result yaad rakh sakte hain. So what is that result? If we have a vector and that is making angle theta with horizontal, so directly remember its horizontal component will be a cos theta and the vertical component will be a sine theta. Also, this triangle needs to be remembered. This is 37 degree. This is 3, this is 4, this is 5. This is 90. Definitely, this should be 53 by angle sum property of triangle. So from here, you can find anything cos 37, sin 37, tan 37, cos 53, sin 53, and tan 53. Anything you can find if you remember this triangle and its sides along with the angles. So whatever we learned today regarding vectors, they are quite important. And in the next class, we will do the questions from the modules based on the major portion of vector that we have covered till now. Any doubt anyone has? Any doubt? So no doubts, right? So okay, then in the next session we can meet and do the module questions. All right, everyone, see you all in the next class.
Thank you, sir.
All right, bye everyone. और ये
सब याद करेंगे सर,
ना? हाँ, ये सब याद करेंगे. Derivation समझना है and you have to remember these results. चलो, bye bye.